Hi, I'm Captain Sarah Healy with Adelaide City Salvos, doing the second part of the discipleship experiment of John chapter 21, 1 to 14, Jesus and his miraculous catch of fish. Now I'm told I've got 30 seconds to get your attention before you disappear off to watch the next clip, so I'm going to talk to you today about miracles, miracles I've seen, and hopefully miracles you'll be able to identify in your own life as well. So miracle is described as something that's extraordinary, that is unreally explainable other than anything but divine intervention. And the beauty of the passage that we've been exploring this week is that Jesus did amazing ones with his disciples, but they were just in everyday things. I mean, Jesus in this passage could have made the heavens rain fish. He could have made fish miraculously appear in the boats. But in this passage, he made the disciples do the work, which I always thought was interesting. But it's also been interesting for me this week is the more I explore this passage, the more I talk to others about it, the more he is revealing to me about what he's actually doing and why. My challenge when I first studied this passage was to be hearing his voice and doing, listening for that stranger on the shore telling me to try something different and going and doing it and letting him sort of do the miracle through that. Now I have to admit, I have probably failed at that because I haven't really done a lot differently. However, through these conversations about this passage, he's been showing me just what he is already doing and those everyday ordinary miracles that he's doing along the way. And it's been really quite exciting. So I've got three key areas I want to just really briefly, to keep you interested, talk about. Firstly, is I had a birthday this week. And the miracle for me is the fact that we've only been in this country a short while in Australia. And I've been so blessed this week of other people just sharing and just loving on me for my birthday. We've made new contacts. We've got a new place. We had a birthday in isolation, but yet I just was overwhelmed by people who shared love with me and encouraged me on my birthday. And it is just a miracle that we've been accepted so quickly into a new community and people actually like us. We shouldn't be surprised. I mean, we're okay people. But it was just overwhelming the way that people genuinely have accepted Shane and I into this different culture. We're New Zealanders in Australia. But it's a miracle that they still like us and we love them too. And secondly, my second point of where I've seen miracles this way is I've been blessed, but these people that we've only known a short time are really opening up. I've had some really good conversations this week of people being vulnerable with me, sharing some deep heart hurts and pains and journeys that they're going through. And I don't know about you, to actually open up and to trust somebody enough to share some of these things, that's a miracle in itself. Because we do put up our walls, we do put up our barriers, we do have a level of distrust often amongst others. So those who shared with me this week, thank you. I don't take it for granted that you opened yourself up like this. I know how hard it is to do. And I pray and I'm asking God all the time that I don't betray that, that I'm being his voice in those situations as I listen to him as to how I can best to be a friend, be a leader, and be a disciple along this journey. So thank you for those. And my third miracle this week is finding joy in a very unexpected place. I was having coffee with Shane and Sally in the car park at church the other day, and there was a man who walked past having a great time, just chatting away, and we recognized him as one of our duo's clients, and he's working through the Towards Independence Recovery Program. Now, he came back a few moments later after Shane had gone carrying a guitar, and he started playing the guitar for us. We had a conversation with him, and just the joy that shone out of this man when he sung. And he played the guitar left-handed, he's self-taught, he's actually really, really good at the guitar with a beautiful voice. And just standing there having a coffee, listen to someone share themselves on playing a guitar and just so excited about it and just the joy that oozed from his face just sort of made me feel so great for the rest of that day that I didn't have to perform a miracle or anything at that point because Jesus was speaking to me through him that there is joy to be found even in some horrible places if we look for it, if we see what Jesus is already doing, if we hear his voice through that. We had an opportunity to share a beautiful moment with a stranger and to really be blessed by him and as we encouraged him as he went on afterwards. So those are some of the miracles I've seen this week, and I'd love to hear where you have seen God at work, where you have seen Jesus be doing things, whether they're the big miracles or just the little everyday ones. Because that's the beautiful thing about our Lord and Savior. We're often praying for the big miraculous healings or world changings or COVID to be taken away. And we too often miss just the things he's already doing. So I really encourage you this week to keep looking for them. Keep listening for those voices. And as I got out of my Bible study last night, to listen to those nudgings that when he is asking of us to do something. Because potentially that little call, that groceries we take around to somebody, that little message could be the answer to one of their prayers and a little miracle in their life for that day. So I've had a great week and I hope you have too. And I'm really looking forward to looking at the next half of this passage in John chapter 21 verses 15 to 25 where Jesus reinstates Peter. A beautiful passage where the impetuous Peter who's jumped out of the boat in this previous passage to be with Jesus is restored. It's a beautiful story of forgiveness and redemption. I look forward to sharing that with you over this coming week as Shane opens that up. Until then, we'll see you again and God bless you each.